Hello, and welcome to today's Grammar Game Show. I'm your host, Will. And if we cannot do what we must will what we can. And of course, let's not forget Leslie, our all-knowing voice in the sky.
Hello, everyone.
Tonight, we're going to ask you three questions about...
the second conditional. That present to future construction with if... that's all about the unreal.
Okay, now let's meet our contestants.
Hello all, my name's Liz.
And contestant number two.
Hello everyone, my name's Rory.
Nice to see you again, Liz. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Fighting fit and ready for action.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah, I hope you do really well.
That sounded nice. No cruel jokes? No false pleasantries?
No, it's all about self-control. I'm trying out a new, nicer me. Welcome, Rory. Tell me something about yourself.
I collect pencils.
What a fascinating hobby. Well, I hope you do really well, both of you. Okay, let's get going. And don't forget, you can play along at home too. It's a double question round, so fingers on those buzzers. First question, what is the formula for a basic second conditional structure?
Is it if plus a present tense and will plus an infinitive?
Ooh, so sorry, Rory, that is the first conditional. But please, dear friend, have another go for free.
Okay, is it if plus a present tense and will plus an infinitive?
Well, no, that was the same answer again. You know, the old me would have killed you for that. Literally plucked your eyes out of your skull. But Liz, why don't you give it a try?
Isn't it if plus a past tense plus would plus an infinitive verb?
And can you give me an example?
I am eating a toffee.
No, that's the present continuous.
I know, just... pushing your buttons.
Oh! Well, great, yeah. So funny.
Wow, you are doing well. The real answer is, if I had more time, I'd have a holiday.
Leslie?
Correct.
Well done. And on to our second question. What is the second conditional used for?
We use a second conditional after a first conditional. First and second, see?
Yes, I can see what you've done there. It's logical, but not right, I'm afraid. Liz?
It's used for a hypothetical present or future situation and its consequence.
Leslie?
Correct! The second conditional structure is used for an unreal or extremely unlikely present or future situation and its consequence. Its formula is if plus the past simple or continuous and would plus an infinitive verb. For example, if I were a girl, I'd be called Leslita.
Oh, what a lovely name. Well done, Liz. 6 points to you. And Rory, you are very good at pushing that buzzer, aren't you? Yes, 1 point to you. On to our second round. Look at these two sentences. One is in the first conditional and one is in the second conditional. I want to know what the difference in meaning is. If I leave now, I will get home early. If I left now, I would get home early.
My name's Rory.
Well, that's wonderful to know, good friend. Liz?
Isn't it something to do with the speaker's perception of a situation? With the first conditional, the speaker believes that something is possible and might actually happen. With the second conditional, the speaker says something is unlikely or unreal.
Oh, wow. What an informative answer. Let's see if it's correct. Leslie, old friend?
It is correct. Many ideas can be expressed in either the first or second conditional. They both talk about a present or future time, after all. The difference is that when using a first conditional, the speaker believes that an event is possible or real. But if they use the second conditional, they are saying it's unlikely or impossible.
6 points to you, Liz.
This is like a whole new you. I like this, Will.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, me too. I'm sleeping better, I've got more energy, I don't spend hours checking myself out in front of the mirror. Let's move on to our final round. Which of these sentences is incorrect? If I were rich, I'd buy a yacht. If you were rich, you'd buy a yacht. If he were rich, he'd buy a yacht. And if they were rich, they'd buy a yacht. Rory, is this a proper answer?
Yes.
Oh, are you sure?
Yes.
Oh, well then go on, old friend. Give it a go.
I choose present perfect.
Liz.
I think C is wrong. It should be if he was.
Leslie.
Sorry, Liz. None of them are incorrect. In the second conditional, people commonly put the verb be into the form were for any pronoun, including I, he, she, and it. It is frequent to hear both styles, although many consider the were form to be more formal.
Oh, I'm so silly. I knew that and forgot it.
Oh, you were doing really well. You have 20 points anyway. And to you too, Rory. Well, that brings us to the end of today's Grammar Game Show. Let's count out the points. And the winner is... both of you. Oh, you're both winners in my book.
Hang on. He didn't even answer one question right. Why does he win too?
Well, I can't drop him down the pit. It wouldn't be good for the new calm me. I'm much nicer now.
But don't you miss it? The thrill of the drop.
The drop?
Drop. When was the last time you...
the drop? Well, it has been a while.
You must be really strong to just... drop the drop.
Drop the drop. Drop the drop. Drop the drop. Drop the drop. Drop the drop.
Oh, heck! Drop. And bring him back up. And drop him back down. Oh, release the clowns. It looks like we'll need another contestant. So much better. I'm back.
And my prize? I'm fine.
We'll see you again next week where you can play for another prize. Thanks for joining us. Say goodbye, Leslie.
Alvida, Leslie.
Oh. See you next time.